comes the cautionary tale of one of the 90s most beloved character actors, Vance Chadwick. Known for his unmistakable catchphrase and trademark smirk, the once promising teen star would go from household name to shameless glory hog. A veritable mess and certainly no stranger to the law in his adult years, Vance's insatiable thirst for attention would serve as a warning to all young actors getting into the...
On yet another canceled TV show. That's three in a row for those of you keeping score as Mr. Ratings Poison strikes again. Amanda, do we have that sound effect?
My man fought Bruno Mars, though. How you gonna make Uptown Funk throw down? Vince, bro, what are you doing?
Whoa!
Are y'all tired of feeling alone, overlooked, powerless in your own personal story? Like you, we understand what it is to feel lost, to feel as if you have no control. But by following in the footsteps of the All-Father, you will know what it is to be understood, nurtured, loved. To feel that you have support as you reclaim your soul in the face of the demons before us. We will be your friends, your family, your source of strength. Together, we will thrive. Together, we can reshape the world the way it was always meant to be. And together, we will find that which we seek, deliverance. Are you ready? Are you ready to discover the fantastic, capable, loving person you were always meant to be? Walk with me, child. Walk the path of salvation until our day comes.
Cheap getting all this real estate. But here at the Paradise Compound, it's faith, not money, that brings us together.
Good morning, Miss Loretta.
Morning, Chipper. Y'all, Chipper here celebrated a whole 5 years under the guidance of the All-Father just last week. How's it going so far?
Not me, no.
You see, like a lot of our new recruits, Chipper here had reached rock bottom like you wouldn't believe.
That's right, y'all. I was in a real bad way. I was drinking like a fish, constantly chasing my next high, and sucking all kinds of...
Look at Chipper now! A full-on house manager at rank 4.
Why, Miss Loretta, now how long have you been a part of the church?
Oh, honey, now you're just trying to make me blush. Well, for y'all's information, my whole life.
Your whole life? Well, gee golly, that must put you at a rank.
Rank 7, but going on rank 8. Now, don't go being intimidated by all that. No matter what our ranks are, every member is to be treated with the utmost respect. We are all the same here. Every one of us.
Unacceptable, Rhonda! Do you hear that? Yeah, no, that's the sound of nothing going on here in Bumfuck, Georgia, because somebody's agent didn't know what she booked him for.
Excuse me.
Oh, great, look. They're all giving me the stink eye now. Are you happy now, Mom?
Right here.
Sorry, just had a confirmed call time with my soon-to-be ex-assistant, Rhonda.
Reception out here is brutal.
With good reason. You know, it's funny you even have that phone, considering all personal effects, specifically mobile devices, were to be confiscated before orientation. Mr.
Vance Chadwick?
Reality show bad boy?
Lovable goofball neighbor Richie on 90s sitcom Red Dads? Come on! Oh, you gotta remember this.
Say what? So anyways, I kind of lied to the guys at the front about not having a phone, because I was already running late, plus I was 83% sure my assistant, Rhonda, got me an almond milk latte and not cashew milk. I was like, Rhonda, are you trying to kill me?
With all due respect, Mr. Chadwick, I could literally feel my soul claw its way out of my mouth.
Right. Sorry. Cult intro. All right, let's go.
Inaccuracy notwithstanding, I'll be having a talk later with security about protocol. But in the meantime, please follow all given instructions as outlined by the Path of Salvation's sacred text. Now, you can read. Right, Mr. Chadwick?
Like a fox.
Then everyone take out your good books.
Oh, goddammit.
And as I alluded to earlier, confidentiality is paramount. Now, some of you may have heard some local journalists have been starting to paint us with a rather unflattering brush. They call us crazy, delusional, a cabal of brainwashed religious psychopaths. Naturally, y'all, this just ain't true. So before we send you off to your assigned cabins, if any of you have any questions about our practices or beliefs, please ask them now. Yes, darling.
Are we ever going to get to see the Allfather?
Oh, of course. But despite the Allfather's constant communication with God, his children are his number one priority. In fact, his daily sermon is the highlight of our day. Ain't that right, Chipper?
Praise thee, Miss Loretta. Praise thee.
How about you, Sugar?
Yes, how long would it take for all of us to find salvation?
Excellent question. Well, first, salvation is exclusive to those of rank 10, which at the moment is held solely by the Allfather. But I suggest not placing too much value on rankings or timings. It's the journey, not the destination.
Yeah, last question. This isn't going to end up, you know, badly for us.
Whatever do you mean?
Like, we're not going to end up on the news?
The news? Sweetheart, the only way we'd end up on the news is if everyone realizes how serious we are.
Yeah, that's really not helping.
Well, I tell you what, because you're just so gosh darn curious, I think that should be acknowledged. As a matter of fact, curiosity is the first step to enlightenment. So, how'd you like to graduate to rank 2?
Holy shit, for real? Like, right off the bat?
Right off the bat! Forget the cabin we've assigned you. I think you're already fit for the House of Giving. Sam Peachy.
Well, yeah.
Good. Now, why don't you follow Chipper and scamp on over to that nice little cabin over there and tell him that Loretta says you're good to go.
Oh, you mean that one over there, isolated from the rest with the red door?
Mm-hmm, red is the blood of an unbeliever, yep.
Well, that doesn't sound sinister or anything. Thanks, Loretta. See you later, losers. Is he still gonna read that book?
Now, if there ain't any more pertinent questions, your reawakening will be happening at the end of the week. Now, worship happens 3 times a day in the House of Truth, with the last one right before the 7 o'clock orgy. Please get acquainted with your designated roommate and house manager, as indicated by your arm patches. And remember, y'all, may the love of the Allfather wash over you all. Until our day comes.
Until our day comes.
Ciao.
Set alarm for 6:45. Name of event? Orgy.
I know I'm going to regret this, but you wouldn't happen to be in the House of Balance, would you?
House of what? Sweet! House 69!
Wait, what? No, let me see that. Okay, this is not a 69, it's a yin-yang.
Whoa! Racist!
No, it's a yin-yang. It's a Chinese symbol for... Okay, God, there has to be some kind of a mistake.
Yo, there's no mistakes when it comes to 69s.
Ooh, you all talking about 69s?
Fuck yeah, we are! Me and,
Jessica.
Yeah, we're both in the 69 house. We're apparently waiting to meet our manager.
Oh, but that's me.
Oh,
just so you know, Chipper, he doesn't speak for me.
It's okay, Sister Jessica. Brother Vance is just settling into this role all actor like. He is an actor, right?
Sadly, yes. Mm-hmm.
God, I'm famous. What did you last see me on, Jess? Was it on VH1? MTV Quattro?
TMZ? You're the guy who got beat up by Bruno Mars.
Oh, who's gonna go fight Bruno Mars? You know, he got your grenade for you.
That hairy little hobbit didn't know who I was.
So you swung at him?
It was on a red carpet.
It was an AIDS walk.
That had a red carpet on it somewhere. Can we just get off this, please? You know, some of us have to get on with whatever it is that we do around here.
Oh, personal salvation?
Yeah, obviously that too. But serious question. This orgy. Does it start exactly at 7 o'clock?
Chipper, look, I know reawakening's at the end of the week, but I really want to get started on the teachings. Any chance I can unpack my things now?
Of course, eager beaver. You know, Vance, you might learn something.
So is this like a regular orgy? Or is it like one of those orgies where it's a bunch of girls in bear suits, and I'm in a salmon suit, and the bear, and the bears are hungry for salmon, but there's only one salmon for all the bears, because that gets wild.
Let's just go, let's just go.
Oh my God, somebody kill me.
Chadwick?
Vance Chadwick Allfather, actor turned raging dumpster fire. Says here his heyday was in the 90s. In fact, journalists call him the Hollywood Conqueror, which on account of he just won't die. Would you like me to revoke his membership?
Oh, no, that won't be necessary. In fact, I think we can use this. You know, this country loves itself a good comeback, so, we can turn Mr. Chadwick into something they can be proud of. Everybody wins.
Meaning?
Meaning we take care of him, Loretta.
Of course,
now.
Your Holiness.
Now, is there anyone else?
No one of any note.
I feel the love of our God ebbing here, Loretta. As someone so close to salvation, your productivity leaves me wanting.
I apologize.
Oh.
It's just...
As our sacred texts say, apologies without actions are merely words on the zephyrs of the Mojave.
Sir?
It means you can leave now, Loretta, but leave your notes. The All Father wishes to commune with God about this Vance Chadwick.
Actually, Your Holiness.
Shh.
What are we listening for?
The voice of our Lord. But sometimes the All Father hears buzzing when things are about to annoy him. You understand? Buzz, buzz. You hear that?
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, continue.
It's important, Your Holiness. I wanted to talk to you about ranking. That is, if you could spare a few minutes.
Not this again. Loretta, if the All Father's told you once, he's told you 1,000 times. We have a system in place here.
I understand that. It's just, you know, I've been ranked 7 for 3 years now, a very long 3 years. I was just hoping, with your blessing, that I could get transferred to another role or perhaps another department entirely.
Transferred? What's wrong with recruiting?
Well, introducing new members to the Path of Salvation has been a very rich and rewarding experience.
But?
I just can't take it anymore. I feel like I'm, with all due respect, babysitting. Maybe if I were to move to marketing or production or maybe even lore with you?
Lore? Don't be ridiculous. Now that role is strictly for me and the Keeper of Secrets.
Exactly, and ever since Alvin, you know.
No. We talked about this now. Alvin did not, his soul was not pure enough. And he clumsily fell into a noose hanging from the ceiling, as you do.
Regardless, the position's empty. I just think at this point in my journey, a mentorship with you could be mutually beneficial.
Huh? The Lord is telling me he finds umbrage with that suggestion.
Oh, the Lord always says that!
For good reason. See, the All Father needs another brilliant mind on par with his to hear the song of the angels. So, someone whose mind vibrates on a similar frequency. Now, your ambition has been noted, Loretta. Well, let's face it, you're just not ready. The position of Keeper of Secrets will be filled when the Lord deems it so.
But, Dad!
Oh, my God! The All Father don't respond to Dad! You know this! Look, simply because you are one of many that have sprung from His Holiness' ever-potent loins, don't give you special rights. But remember, humility is a flower from which only the wisest hummingbird sips. I thought your mother Irene would have taught you that.
My mom's name is Kathy!
Oh, buzz, buzz!
Beautiful, just like you always said, but you were right. Something's off. Reawakening's on Friday, and I don't know whether I'm excited or terrified. My housemates are unique. Chipper's a sweetheart, if a total zealot. The other is, how can I say this, a moron. Considering what I'm trying to do here, he's either going to be a huge help or a total liability.
What's up?
Hey, you up? Again?
Yes, again. Have you tried sleeping? You hear that next door, right?
The House of Joy.
That's the House of Joy?
Look, if you're bored, there's plenty to do around here.
No internet, no cell phones, no social media besides listening to 50 Shades of Grace over there. What's a guy like me supposed to do?
Go to worship, help with the farm.
Ugh, boring.
Do you even know what you signed up for here?
Please, I'm famous. I don't need to know anything. Besides that, this place is in some serious need of vitamin V. That's me.
Look, I don't know what your agent told you, but this isn't an audition for anything. You know the only cameras here are for our video testimonials, right?
Gross. Like the real world?
Okay. All Father wants to know what we're thinking about every week so his sermons resonate. It's in the book.
Again with the book? Just tell me when it's on Audible.
Okay, you need a phone for that, so.
Don't remind me. Just keep writing your little story over there.
My what?
The only people who have journals like that are either stand-ups or journalists. And trust me, babe, you're way too confident to be a comic.
Okay, asshole. First, I'm not your babe. Secondly, I'm not doing a story.
Yeesh, okay. Forget I said anything. In fact, I'm kind of glad about it. It lets me know where I stand.
What are you on about?
In the industry? People lie so much they stutter when they tell the truth. So I know bullshit when I smell it. And you? Ooh. You don't ruin my deal, I won't ruin yours. Sound good?
You're unbelievable.
And you're hiding something.
All right, you two. In preparation for the reawakening on Friday, we want to make sure that you have all the proper accoutrements. Brother Jimmy, the box, if you will.
Nice! Wardrobe! Hey, I know you! Didn't you, like, die or something?
Death is not an end, but a transformation, so saith the All-Father.
Yo! Yo fucked him up!
The love of our Lord extends beyond sight and is felt by all of his children.
Is this...
I hear off about what happens on Friday Chillin' Night stays on Friday Chillin' Night. Sorry, sweetheart, there you go.
Wait, is that what I think it is?
Oh, barf, I'm a Gryffindor.
No, it means you're gonna help lead the reawakening ceremony.
Oh, now we're talking.
The Shroud of Mercy means that the All-Father has entrusted you, Brother Vance, with the eyes of God.
Okay, that sounds lit as fuck.
Oh, it is very lit as fudge, but you should feel honored.
Wow, and why shouldn't he? He's been here for, like, 2 hours?
I'm sensing some judgment here, Jess.
Oh, go fuck yourself, D-lister.
Hey, now I may be one of the fun house managers, but this is still the house of balance, y'all. We're about inner peace, because without peace, there's no love. And without love, there's no faith. And without faith...
You chop up the bodies and burn the remains. Ha ha! Right?
Why don't you go make a joke like that, Vance? You know that smoke will just bring attention.
You had me going there. Oh, man. You had me going.
I know. So anyway, why don't we make sure that those all fit, and I'll come fetch you around for supper. Here we're having coons, stew, and knife. Somebody's just rumbling thinking about it. Come on, Jimmy. Back to the house of giving for you.
Punishment does not exist, only love. The pain.
The laugh of man with this one. Until our day comes, y'all.
Until our day comes.
Toodles.
Wow. A day in and you've already set yourself up for a spectacular crash and burn.
Envy's Maximus. Do I smell jealousy?
Of you, please.
It sounds like you're pretty pissed I got the easy in here.
Okay, you seriously need to get over yourself.
I need to get over myself? You know, for someone who thinks I'm just some entitled prick, you may want to look in the mirror.
Oh, I'm entitled? Says the guy the 90s threw out and never wanted back. The douche canoe who'd sell out his own mom for a 2-minute segment on a Real Housewives reunion show.
Wait, you can do that?
You're a joke. A joke that's been on more canceled shows than anyone in TV history.
Yeah, well, you know what this joke sees? An uptight, unhappy little journalism major who realized way too late in life that the world doesn't give a shit about her. Hoping that some Twitter mention from MSNBC might make her sad, normie little life
give it a little meaning. Does that sound about right?
You don't know a thing about me or why I'm here.
Really?
Because it sounds like I nailed it.
I'm only gonna say this once. We are not friends. We're barely acquaintances. So if you see me around and you wanna say hi, do me a favor and go deep throat a chainsaw.
That's not even possible.
Don't look at me, don't read me, don't even say my name. You understand?
Please, I already forgot it. And you can forget about borrowing this stupid fucking scarf. Expecto Patronum.
For today, my children, I want you all to look around at your fellow walkers of the path. Black hair, brown hair, long, red, short, tall, young, and old. Now, outside these walls, the world looks at these things to put you in boxes, separate you, and not just from each other, but from the truth. You hear me, church?
Amen.
I said, you hear me, church?
Amen. Amen.
Holy shit! Is that that Colonel Sanders?
You see, the truth, much like God, is absolute. Not like the lies we see every day around us. Whores putting their bodies online to make you hate yourself. Snakes on Capitol Hill saying they're for the people as they grovel to corporate interests. Big tech telling you that the secret to self-worth is a thumbs up or a blue check mark. That ain't truth, y'all.
Amen, all father.
Y'all want to know the truth?
Yeah. Yes, all father.
I said, do you want to know the truth?
We want the truth.
Give me that truth. The big truth.
Everything always comes back around to God. And as it stands, man's relationship with the Almighty has left him cold. But you see, the path of salvation is here to course correct. Because when I look out at y'all in them pews, I don't see black hair, brown hair, short and tall. I see strength. I see faith. Testify, not Spotify. We don't Netflix and chill. We kneel and repent. And until our day comes, y'all, we will not be denied. We will not be written off. We will be ready to fight the demons at our door. So, go with God, my children, and let our freedom ring, damn it!
Praise be to the Almighty! Praise be to God!
Oh, that was a monologue. That was a fucking monologue. Like Daniel Day-Lewis. Fuck! Fucking Daniel Day-Lewis.
Out of here! If you weren't wearing the shroud, you're at a rank 1, and I'm at a rank 7. So when I tell you to hush, you do it. You're lucky I even acknowledge you. Amazing sermon, All-Father.
You give me too much praise. Now, who might this be?
That's Vance Chadwick.
Loretta, please. Let the man speak for himself. What's your name, son?
Well, I'm, Vance Chadwick.
Actually, hold on. Wait a minute. Vance, right?
Yes! I can't believe you know who I am!
Well, know you? Come on, now. Say what?
Yo! Fucking Brad Dads!
Oh! You were quite hilarious in that program, oh, young man.
At least someone acknowledges it.
I was a big fan of that show too. Right?
Loretta. Right? I got some things scheduled, but be a doll and take care of those, would you? The All-Father's gonna have him a nice conversation with this fine young man about his duties later this week. Seeing as he'll be wielding the eyes of God and all. They say there's only two types of folks in this world. The saints who think they're sinners and the sinners who think they're saints. Which one do you reckon you are, huh? I ain't no right or wrong answer here, because I see it in your eyes regardless. Guilt. Now, you might have the rest of the flock fooled as to your intentions, but not me, huh? And certainly not God. What you think you're going to get out of this, huh? You looking to humiliate me, boy?
No. Not at all. No, I'm totally in on this this community.
I think the word you're looking for is cult. Huh? Go on, say it. God sees it on the tip of your tongue.
Well, I mean, you said it, not me, so. Oh, okay, right.
Brother man. You see, a cult's got ulterior motives, see? Money, power, not us. See, many years ago, me and my beautiful wife, Bethany, God rest her soul, believed that society had a way of complicating things. So we struck out on our own and came up with everything you see here. And for one reason. What do you think that is, son?
Tax exemption.
Absolution. See, at the end of the day, we're all looking for the same thing. Forgiveness in the eyes of the Lord. But I look at you and I see someone's looking for something else. Redemption.
I don't really know what you're talking about.
Oh, I think you do. And that's where I believe we might have something in common. See, I can stand right there on that stage and preach the good word till the rapture comes, but what's the use if it's the same people in them pews every doggone day?
Mm-hmm. You're looking to expand.
Indeed. And as much as it pains me, what do people respect more than God nowadays? Influence. And just look what the Lord done delivered to my doorstep. A full-on celebrity.
Oh, come on! Full-on might be landing on a bit.
Ooh, me a little fade.
You have no idea.
See, my proposition is simple. My proposition is simple, Brother Vance. Clearly, you're looking to increase your notoriety. And as it so happens, so am I. You help elevate the path in the eyes of the public, the path elevates you. Simple as that. It means you get promoted.
Nice!
So is that a yes, Brother Vance?
Oh, hell yeah!
Then tell me you believe.
I believe.
Oh, come on now. I'm gonna need a little more conviction than that. Lord knows my children need to be inspired if you're gonna be their golden boy. I believe. Do you wish to recognize me as the All-Father, the infallible voice of our Lord, the Alpha and Omega, until we lay at the feet of God himself? I believe! Good. Because if you don't, I'll fucking bury you out back myself.
Well, shit. You could have just led with that.
You know, it works in mysterious ways. Let's talk about Friday, shall we? Come on, my son.
By the grace of the All-Father, this week has been trying. The new members are showing a lot of promise, but I don't know. I can't help but feel like something's
fucking awesome. Are you kidding me? I'm not gonna lie. I was pissed when I first got here, but that thing they're having me do for the reawakening sounds pretty sweet.
Sweet. She was really sweet. And whatever good she saw here, I guess I'm looking for it too, you know? It's funny, I'll see her name in the records, and I can't help but think
about Coon Stew. Now, the key is you gotta let it simmer. Now, I know, it's tempting to just dig into that fat little bastard when he got them all suckling in that pot, but really, it's about
patience. I just need to practice patience. But how can I? How can I be patient when I could see what should be my spot and standing in it is
Vance Chadwick, rank 5. Ooh. Or maybe I'm rank 7 like Luann? Shit. This better mean I get my own.
Ceremony's in just a few hours. After hearing the stories, I didn't think I had it in me to come here, let alone make it this far. I guess you could say I'm feeling a little
nervous? But nah, those two will be fine. I mean, what's the worst that could happen? Until our day comes, y'all.
Until our day comes. Until our day comes.
Look, you Bruno Mars!
Thank you.
still not talking to me?
And thus the Lord, in all his infinite wisdom and glory,
God, you're so petty,
hath bestowed thee, O Father, with the power to realign, and reawaken. And to those wayward sheep who have found their way home, I say, open your eyes, hearts, and minds to the love of our Lord.
Praise be to the All-Father.
All-Father.
Sister Jessica.
Yes, All-Father.
Have you renounced the wickedness of your former life? Are you ready to walk the path?
Yes, All-Father.
Brother Vance.
Yup.
Have you renounced the wickedness of your former life and prepared to walk the path?
For sure.
Chipper, my child, is the House of Balance ready to accept these candidates and relieve them of their slumber?
Yes, Your Holiness.
And is the Lord's steady gaze upon us, Sister Loretta?
Yes, Your Holiness.
Then let the reawakening commence! Brother Vance, seeing as you wear the shroud of mercy, you are hereby exempt from this rite, so saith the Lord. He who wears the shroud, please bring forth the eyes of God.
The what now?
The box, you idiot.
Oh, now you want to talk?
Just get the fucking box, Vance.
All right.
Open it!
Holy shit.
Take the eyes, my child, and fix its gaze upon Sister Jessica.
Whoa. All-Father, when you said the eyes of gold, I was thinking Ray-Bans.
We must see if she is pure of heart, Brother Vance.
All-Father, come on.
If you believe as strongly as you say you do, you will do your part.
But
do your part!
Listen, Jess, I really didn't
pull the trigger, Vance.
What? No!
Is that doubt a sense?
No! It's a different word. It's similar.
Then let the judgment commence now!
It's okay, I believe.
Does anybody else think this is crazy?
Oh, pull the trigger, son!
You can do it, buddy!
I can't! Let's play the shrinker!
I can't!
Do it or we're both dead!
The eyes of God do not lie, my child. The Lord has deemed you pure to walk the path of salvation.
Praise be to the All-Father.
And praise to your new Keeper of Secrets!
What?
In this very moment I have heard the voice of our Lord, and he hath proclaimed with great vigor that Brother Vance shall serve unto me in the House of Truth!
Oh, darn, that's fantastic!
Oh, Father! Surely this can't be true!
You question me again?
Don't give a fuck what the sacred text says.
How are you the Keeper of Secrets?
Dude, I don't even know what that is.
Of course you don't. I'm sorry, All-Father. This just ain't fair.
Loretta, you're embarrassing the both of us.
Get it the fuck together.
Look, I'm just being his Tom Cruise.
What does that even mean?
It means this whole thing's a show? $10 is this thing isn't even loaded.
You know, sometimes I wish I weren't a part of this family. Sometimes I wish you weren't my father!
Well, I am your
father!
In fact, I'm everybody's
father!
And I'll be everybody's
father!
Until God himself drives me dead!
Don't believe me, just watch!
Play that, son of a bitch! Eyes of God, I deemed thee, all Father, impure. Wait, Miss Loretta, what that mean?
Oh, no, 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 No! Not him!
Oh, you gotta be shitting me.
There's something about this in the book, isn't there? Reach out to us, baby.
So no one told you your life was gonna be this way. Your job's a joke, you're broke, your love life's DOA. Are you ready to rise up? Tired of throwing away your shot?
All right, keeping it a buck here, the world sucks. But if you sacrifice, work hard, and promise to walk with me, the Allfather,
I can make it suck less! Does that sound weird? Less sucky! Does that sound better? Oh, what the fuck?
Respect between your frequent absences at worship, your reluctance to watch the video testimonials, and this misguided initiative to erect a statue of you.
Erect.
We are on track to lose a third of our congregation by the fall. In the interest of the path, may I advise you to start focusing on your responsibilities, or maybe even part with a few of them.
I hear you, but no can do. V Diddy's in charge now, so that means everything's gonna work out fine. These people believe in me.
Do they, though?
Mm-hmm. Why wouldn't they?
What's the first tenet of the payoff?
Important.
How many tenets are there?
Enough.
What is a tenet?
I want to say time travel?
Who in the Lord's name is this?
Oh, well, when you mentioned our recruitment problem, I gave Chipper here one of my phones. He put something out online and boom! New recruits.
And you just opened up the gates.
Cool, huh?
Not cool! You can't just open us up like that, fans! We've got rules here!
And rules can change. Besides, it's a cool story. Tell her, Chimps.
Totes and goats, Principal Loretta. And not 1 hour after I put the call out on Craigslist, did the good Lord put Brother Brutus in front of the compound with a whole truck full of nifty cameras and microphones and all that fun stuff. Ain't that right? Oh, my fault. Ain't that right, Brutus? First abnormality. Poor guy. Good ears on his chest. Gotta talk directly into it, else he can't understand you. That's the damnedest thing.
How you liking the path so far, buddy?
Oh, I've been watching you guys for quite some time. Thanks for the hospitality.
Oh, well, thank you, Buckaroo, for donating all this fancy surveillance equipment.
Oh, I didn't pay for it.
And the miracles just keep coming. And the miracles just keep coming.
Just
busy, I know. It's just, I'm not quite sure what you expect of me. I know we all have our journeys in life, but if this is some sort of test, I'm not even sure I want to pass. I mean, is this my path, Lord? Is this my purpose?
Loretta, are you praying?
Oh, Sister Jessica, rank one. How you doing, sweetheart?
I'm okay. It's just working a double at the farm with so many people gone. You all right?
Me? I'm just peachy.
You sure? Because it looks like you're...
Like I'm crying? No. It's just the love of the Lord trickling out of my eye holes. One month, Sister Jessica. All it took was 1 month with Vance in charge to lead this place astray. He doesn't know how to inspire. He doesn't know a lick of our faith, and I'm pretty sure he thinks the word homily is a slur.
He's not the perfect choice by a long shot, but who is?
Me, Jessica! Do you know what it's like to work so hard for your entire life and not once be considered for what you know you deserve?
Hey, I get it.
Do you though? You don't know what it's like having Alistair King as your father.
Loretta, supervise the new recruits. Loretta, write the sermon for Tuesday. Loretta, remove the teeth so they can't check the dental records.
The good book says no one but God can judge us, but sure didn't feel like it. Not for me.
You sound just like my mom.
Your mom would remove teeth from the dead body.
Oh, no, not that part. But look. No. Years before my mom met my dad, she was married to this really rotten guy. And outside of being a mom, all she ever wanted was to be a pastor. Now you'd think her husband would be supportive, or at least pretend to be, but oh no, not this guy. And it wasn't because he didn't think she'd be good at it. Quite the opposite. He was afraid of how it would make him look.
So did she ever do it? The whole pastor thing?
I mean, after leaving him, eventually, yeah. And she was so good, Loretta. She was compassionate and relatable, funny. She was amazing. And all her best stuff she wrote right here. Reading her words, writing it myself now. It's almost like talking to her again. She sounds great.
Yeah, she was.
But, like you, she had her hurdles. Not everybody is receptive to hearing about faith from a 30-something divorcee, you know?
So, what do you think she'd say now?
Fuck 'em.
Wait, so you're saying that I should be fine with Vance Chadwick leading what's left of us down the path?
It doesn't matter what you're fine with. If this place is gonna stay afloat, if you believe in what we're doing here, we have to help him.
Even if he doesn't have a clue what he's doing?
Oh, especially if he doesn't have a clue what he's doing.
You know, you're not so bad at sermons yourself.
Oh, let's not get crazy. I just want this place to be a little bit better. And besides, sermons are the all-father's thing.
Well, we could always just shoot him.
Loretta.
I'm just joking. I rarely get to do that. Jeez Louise, would you listen to me? You know, Daddy used to say, Loretta, pride is the one-winged albatross that even the most cunning of minnow can't escape.
You know, he's probably just making that up on the spot, right?
Yeah. Well, thanks for this, Jess. Ranks notwithstanding. Feels pretty nice calling you sister. Hope the feeling's mutual.
Well, come on, sugar. Let's go find ourselves a wayward sheep.
Okay.
I'm not you again. I get it. I suck. I kindly hit the bricks.
Not getting off that easy. Loretta, go.
Sister Jessica, this is the house of salvation. We can't just openly question God's grace.
All Father.
Yeah.
I think you're a terrible leader. And I think that you see this role as something to brag about, but really it's something you don't deserve. I think that you're angry about all your failures in life. So you come to places like this to feel a big deal, when really you're just as sad and helpless as the rest of us. You reckon you're some kind of lone wolf, when really you're just alone. Did I miss anything, Jess?
Yeah, he's a dick.
Oh, right. And you're a dick. That's it? No comeback? No smart-ass response?
I know, it's weird. I'm trying. It's like normally I've got like a dozen of those in the compartment, but I heard what you said, and I feel, I don't know. Oh, God, what's the word?
Bad?
Yeah. How do I stop that?
You don't. You fix it. The reality is this. You keep things going the way they are, pretty soon you'll have nobody left.
Nobody but Rhonda.
No one, Vance. The numbers support it. Morale is down across the board, and everybody sees it but you. And newsflash, if there's no one left, that only means one thing.
How about another canceled show? Again.
You all right?
It's times like these. There's a poet who once said, sometimes the world looks perfect, nothing to rearrange. Sometimes you just get a feeling like you need some kind of change. But no matter what the odds are this time, nothing's gonna stand in my way. This flame in my heart, it's like a long-lost friend, bringing every dark street a light at the end. Standing tall on the wings of my dreams, rise and fall like the wings of my dreams.
Okay. You're an idiot. Loretta, this is the theme song to Perfect Strangers.
You're the theme song to Perfect Strangers.
Okay, screw this. Vance, sit your ass down and listen up. Look, you may be the face of this place, but we know how it operates. So if the path is going to change for the better, then all three of us are going to have to put our heads together. It's going to suck. We're going to have to get along. But it's what we have to do. Comprende?
Yeah. I guess I'm in over my head here, guys.
Yeah, we know.
Time to go to work.
Oh, barf!
Nothing to rearrange. Sometimes you just get a feeling like you need some kind of change. No matter. gonna stop me now.
Testimonials, members have responded really positively to the most recent mandates, particularly the no branding thing, Taco Tuesday and the dining commons, and lastly, the completion of the 69 house. Yeah.
Okay. Nice.
Other than that, Chipper's doing really well with the new recruits. Loretta is loving the House of Joy, and our numbers have almost doubled in the last 6 months alone.
Who would have thought not killing people would be a selling point?
Yeah. Wi-Fi helps too.
Oh, great idea, by the way.
Honestly, can't believe it's been a whole year since you took over. I hate to say it, but you've done maybe a halfway decent job.
Oh, halfway decent? That's the nicest thing anybody's ever said to me. But I can't take all the credit. Huggies! What up, Loretta?
Oh, Father, keep her secrets.
Is this a punishment?
Reward! This little worm's earned a right to a walk of contrition. It's supposed to compel him to renounce the inequities of his past.
Jess, do you remember doing this?
Nope.
Oh, it's new. I found the House of Joy to be a little old hat, so I took it upon myself to add in some much-needed bylaws.
That's sweet of you.
Ain't it just? Now come here, bitch. Kiss Mama's feet and tell her you're a slut. Okay, that's enough. Bye, y'all.
Oh, well, praise be, y'all, if it isn't the All-Father himself and our Keeper of Secrets. Now, y'all gonna see Miss Jessica later at the House of Truth for one of her homilies. Used to be we wouldn't let no women on stage, but then one night the good Lord spoke to the All-Father in his infinite wisdom and glory, and he said...
She's cool!
Yeah, she's cool! And what saith the Lord shall come to pass?
Brutus! How's my head of security doing? Kicking ass and taking names off, bet. Wet Willie.
Oh, I love this get up, man.
Merci beaucoup, I repeat, merci beaucoup.
De nada. Catch you at the 69 house later.
That is an A firm. Roger that, Chief.
I love it when he calls me that.
Whatever you say. Okay, I need to go prepare for a sermon. Anything else you need, All Father?
Can hear us in here?
No, we cannot.
Oh, sweet. Jess, well, what are the FBI doing here?
I don't know.
Can we help you?
Can we help you?
We have the complex surrounded. Come on with your hands up.
Are you sure you've got the right place?
We have warrants of arrest for Vance Chadwick and the rest of the Baptist Salvation for multiple counts of kidnapping, assault, and murder in the first degree.
Okay, they've got the right place. Not to be that dude, but that was the other guy. We're different now.
Come again?
That's actually a funny story. See, he's dead. I shot him, and now I'm in charge. That sounded bad, didn't it?
Yeah,
Mr. Chadwick, relinquish your weapons. and tell your followers to come out with their hands up.
Wait, what weapons? We got rid of that stupid gun like forever ago.
Well, yeah, that one, but Vance signs off on the armory every week.
The armory's not a sex thing.
How many guns do we have?
A couple dozen assault rifles, a few cases of handguns, let's see, a grenade.
Well, don't forget the C4.
The C4, of course, duh.
Okay, but why?
It's the South.
Be advised, you have 30 minutes to comply or we're storming the complex.
Oh my stars. It's today!
What day?
The one we always talk about!
Wait, until our day comes, that's what that means?
Old All-Father was prepping for the day unbelievers showed up at our doorstep since day one. So it was inevitable, you know, before Ben shot him in the chest.
Oh, for crying out loud.
I don't know about y'all, but I'm not going to jail. I'm a good person, damn it.
Yeah.
Shut up, whore.
Vance, what are you doing?
I'm giving myself up?
Vance! You're our leader! Lead!
Okay, Red State! You want to go out there guns ablaze and be my guest, but I am not dying here!
But you're the All-Father.
Yeah, I'm also a celebrity. The worst that's going to happen to me is a slap on the wrist and a few trending hashtags.
But what about us?
Well, shit. I mean, prison's not that bad! You got 3 hots and a cot! There's a library! A gym! TV privileges! I mean, it's a lot like this place, except for the
freedom?
Well, yeah. When you put it like that.
I know you don't take the faith very seriously, but can you, for once in your life, please think about anyone other than yourself right now? Just what I thought. First sign of trouble, and you go right back to who I thought you were.
Okay, everyone, let's find a place to hole up.
We're not gonna fight?
No, Chipper. Apparently, the only salvation All-Father cares about is his own.
Come on, slut.
You know, for what it's worth, you weren't as bad as I thought.
Thanks, man. Oh, sorry. Thanks, man!
Are you fucking stupid?
Because we are your friends, you never be alone!
The
awesome
who cares about it himself.
This whole place is a grift. Any of you know this?
You disappoint us, Vance.
What? Who's there?
It is I, L. Ron Hubbard, the founder of Scientology.
Shit. Am I dead?
No, it's me who's dead.
Oh, shit. You're dead?
Yes! This is not going the way I thought it was gonna go.
Elrond, this the new guy?
Yeah.
Oh my God! Bill Gates!
I'm David Koresh. Leader of the Branch of Davidians. Waco?
Still nothing.
Hey guys, did I miss the party?
Oh my God, it's Charles Manson!
Of course he knows Charlie.
Well, duh! His crew killed Margot Robbie in that Tarantino movie.
Ooh, Margot Robbie, what a babe.
Oh, I know, right?
Gents, we're wasting time. Vance, we're coming to you today because you need to know you come from a long line of people like us.
Charismatic leaders.
Assholes. And right now, we see you need help.
That's right. And this little predicament you find yourself in right now looks awfully familiar. And take it from me, it ain't gonna end well.
Well, maybe for everybody else, but I'll be fine. I mean, the podcast alone.
Am I right?
Ha ha! Yes.
Wow, Elrond, fuck this guy.
Whoa. What David's trying to say is, you got a lot of people out there counting on you, and you leaving them out to dry like that? That ain't cool, man.
No offense, but why should I take advice from any of you? You're all dead.
Because everyone knows who we are. Google us. There's books, movies, documentaries, you name it. You're just the Rat Dad's guy who got mollywopped by Bruno Mars.
Vance, you're one of the lucky few in this world people dedicate their lives to, no matter what crazy nonsense you're spouting. That's a precious gift.
And because of that, you owe them something.
But I gave them Taco Tuesday.
We're not saying you owe them your life, but you do owe them the illusion. After all, that's all a cult boils down to, Vance. The illusion.
People can believe what they want, but they need to believe in you. Otherwise, you're no leader. You're just a coward.
You don't want to be a coward, do you, bud?
No. I just don't want to be a loser anymore.
Well, going outside and leaving your friends to fend for themselves, that's some loser-ass shit.
Dead ass.
Well, what am I supposed to do?
Be resilient. We have faith. You'll figure it out.
Hey, fellas, Joseph Smith just texted and said we can slide through.
Ooh, I just love Mormon parties.
Godspeed, Vance. We'll see you on the other side.
But what if I don't figure it out? And what the hell's the other side? Elrond? Charlie? Other guy?
This ending with the dadgum cup of Kool-Aid.
Sorry, Chipper, it's all we have. But none of us are gonna suffer, I promise.
It's times like this, I wonder what my father would say.
Nothing helpful, Loretta. Under all that bravado was a sad little man who could never say no to power. It's why he was always in charge, why you never got what you deserved, why his wife left.
Well, honey, the Allfather's wife passed away. She didn't leave.
She did. Alistair never saw this place the way she saw it. Where she saw community, he saw followers. And when it was clear that their visions weren't in line, she packed up her bags and started a brand new life.
Is this keeper knowledge?
Not keeper knowledge, just me. Look, the path of salvation was always meant to be something good. And now that it finally is, we're all looking at prison or worse just because some narcissist couldn't get over my mom. This place was her idea, her work, and he just fucked it all up.
Your mom, the pastor.
I should have been honest with all of you from the beginning, but I didn't know who I could trust. It was wrong. I was wrong. But here we are now with a host of agents ready to storm this beautiful place that we've created together, and I just wish she was here.
What do you think she'd say now?
Fuck him.
Whatever happens,
I love each and every one of you. Till our day comes, y'all.
Everybody! Stop!
All covered?
Weak. Hey, Feds! Y'all still out there?
Are you ready to comply?
Yes.
What?
But before I do, I've got something to say, and I want it all on the record. You ready?
Vance, what are you doing?
Leaving.
Ahem. When I first got here, I thought this was gonna get me back into the mainstream, to get people talking about me again. It wasn't. And what I thought would be, when I became All-Father, what I thought would just be non-stop praise and orgies with a bunch of rednecks turned out to be non-stop praise and orgies with some really cool people. People I don't deserve to lead, let alone be the boss of. You see, according to the ghost of L. Ron Hubbard, I'm an asshole. And if there's one thing assholes are good at, it's taking advantage of people they're supposed to protect. But I can't be that guy. Not anymore. So I'm coming out with my hands raised and I'm taking full responsibility for everything the past's been accused of. All of it was my idea. But I'm doing this on two conditions: that all charges against the rest of the path be dropped, and that you leave this place alone from now on. Deal?
And those are your terms?
Those are my terms.
All right, come on out then, but slowly.
Okay, I don't think we've got a lot of time, and this is probably the last time we'll be together, so here are our last orders of business. Loretta, you've been a rank 7, I probably shouldn't even be acknowledging you. You've been a meticulous, overbearing pain in the ass.
This is how you're gonna start a goodbye speech?
But your passion is what makes this place, and what everyone should strive to achieve. Effective immediately, I'm removing you from the House of Joy, and I'm making you our new Keeper of Secrets.
Are you fooling me right now?
No one cares more about the path than you. Everyone can see that now. Besides, this whole dominatrix thing you got going has got me bricked up. You know what I'm saying? I'm like, thank you. Uh-huh.
You can let go of me now.
Chipper?
Yes, I'm Father?
With Loretta as our new keeper, I'm promoting you to the general manager of all the houses.
Yes.
There's no one our members love more than you, and quite frankly, I don't trust anybody else's recipe for raccoon stew. You got that.
Yeah.
Oh, Brutus, sweet Brutus. I'm gonna miss your smile, your spirit, the way you kept your shirt on during all the orgies. Oh my God! This guy's the informant!
Oh, motherfucking shitballs, I knew it! Who the fuck has an ear on their chest? Brutus, come on!
All right. You got me.
And then there's you. Been riding me since day one, and for good reason. I was selfish and cocky.
Boorish, chauvinistic, feel free to stop me.
But at my worst, you gave me something I couldn't even give myself. A chance to change. You know, when I first got here, Alistair said I was looking for redemption. I guess he was right. So, before I go out there, I want you to know, I need you to know that everything you have taught me, I'm gonna keep it right here. And it's gonna be the best parts of what's sure to be a fuck ton of book deals. Bow, 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 bow! Bow, 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 bow! Look, with Loretta as our keeper, you're not off the hook. I still need somebody to take care of our people. Someone better than halfway decent. Huggies! All right. Peace out, y'all. Goodbye, Jess. Or should I say, All Mother!